Hiya, welcome back to What's Up Doc. Do you want to do a guitar item, Andy, they said?
I certainly do, they said. Trouble with this is that A, it's not plugged in, and B, it's not red. But in the words of Socky Sock Sock, no more of me, and on to our special guest. Would you welcome the man, the myth, the guitar legend that is Mr. Hank Marvin? Next to Hank, the chap that won the chance to have a guitar masterclass with the man himself playing the guitar that was part of his prize, Paul Bestwick. The bit of Paul's letter that we liked was when he said, if Hank Marvin was patient enough to play with Cliff Richard in the 60s, he'd be patient enough to play with me in the 90s. Hank's guitar history is chronicled in the annals of pop catalogues if you want to check it out for yourself. And it's been catalogued too by a chap called James, who sent us a photograph of a painting he did of Hank and the Shadows at various stages during their career. There it is. It's terrific, that. Thank you for that, James. James lives in Scotland and he's 44.
44. Thank you,
but, yeah, but nice to see you. Enjoy the show, James. Thanks for sending that in. That's your past in about 30 seconds.
Good, wasn't it?
Welcome to the show.
Thank you, Andy.
What are you doing for the 90s? What's the project for now?
The project for now, I have a new album coming out next week called Into the Light, and a new single released with Brian May from
that
Queen.
Sounds like an appropriate point to see a clip of that. This is, we showed you some of it last week. It's the Queen song, We Are the Champions. Sorry about that. Just throwing a few shapes with the guys, as they say in rock and roll. Not. You owe a lot to this invention, don't you, the electric guitar?
I certainly do. This appearance I owe to this invention.
I suppose. Yeah. How did it come about? How do we get from the acoustic to this? Why, really?
Well, I think basically with an acoustic guitar, it's very difficult to hear it when there are other instruments playing.
Yeah.
And someone had the bright idea of putting an electronic pickup on it, rather like one of these, to amplify it. But there's a problem associated with those guitars. They tend to feed back quite heavily and make a lot of noise. Yeah.
Oh, right. Simon? Yeah, I see what you mean.
Yeah, not a very musical noise. It'll never be a hit.
No, but so this is essentially a lump of wood, really, isn't it?
Solid wood, Andy, that's correct.
It's the electronic jiggery-pokery that produces the noise.
These pickups here, they're like little little microphones, if you like, and they pick up the string vibrations, put them through the amplifier, and amplify it, of course.
So the shape of the guitar has nothing to do with the sound, which means is why you can get all those rock and roll bands with guitars of bizarre shapes and sizes, yeah?
That's right.
But I bet you've never seen a guitar quite like this one. This is Simon Perry's special invention. It's called a cheese caster.
A cheddar caster?
A cheddar caster,
great.
Yes.
Terrific.
Handy if you, handy if you get a bit peckish, I suppose. But you've stuck with the Strat.
I have.
He invented the cheese caster. A bit of confusion as to actually who invented the electric guitar. That was the question last week. Who invented the first solid wood electric guitar? Facts as you understand them, please.
Well, it would appear that a man called Rickenbacker actually made the first electric guitar, but the first production electric guitar is generally accepted to be made by Leo Fender. It was the broadcaster.
Fine, so we'd have accepted either of those answers, but obviously it was the supplementary bit to the question that we wanted. That's why you wanted the masterclass, and Paul answered that very well. You've stuck with the Stratocaster over the years, though, haven't you?
How do
you get that sound, that, you know, that sort of shadow sound that everybody tries to emulate?
It's a combination of echo, the tremolo arm, and just incredible talent.
That seems reasonable enough. Do you take advantage of all the modern technology these days? Have you got, like, high-tech equipment or not?
Well, we have in the studios, but basically to get my sound, it's very simple. Guitar, amplifier and echo box.
And one of these things, I understand, and you're still using these things.
Yes, what is it?
It's a valve.
It's a valve, yes.
100 years old.
The interesting thing is that most guitarists prefer amplifiers using valves because they have a warmer, more musical sound than solid-state amplifiers.
So, yeah, there you are. Tip if you're a budding guitarist, get yourself a valve amplifier. Paul's a budding guitarist and he's itching to play with his plectrum, if you'll pardon the expression. We promised him a guitar masterclass. I'll leave it to you.
All right, Paul. Let's have a look. One thing you said to me, Paul, you'd like to learn something with using two strings at a time. Yeah. Let's do something in the key of E, starting here on the 4th and 5th fret. That's the one. Then move up 1st and 3rd fingers. Good. 2 frets up. Good. Now we'll start there and do a little phrase that goes like this, using those 3 positions. Genius. And then the next phrase is And we put them together with a slider like this. That's fantastic.
Sorry, I'm sorry.
Thanks for the drums, Andy. Great. Now, I expect, Paul, that you probably, because you've heard me play, would like to learn how to use the tremolo. Maybe something like this.
No.
Well, maybe what about something like...
Have you got 30 years? I can't do that.
Well, I'll tell you what, let's do the one that we were trying to sort of play around with yesterday.
The one I taught you.
Well, I'll tell you what, I hope I don't make any mistakes here. I'm in big manure. Here we go. Eat your heart out, Slash.
If, like me, you're a budding guitarist, but you haven't quite got past bar chords, Hank Marvin's got his guitar tutor out, so you can win one of these if you can answer a very simple question on our phone-in number, which is 0839 33333. Please feel free to keep playing. That's quite all right.
Thank you very much.
Just doing a television programme. Hank mentioned this bit of the guitar here. I call it a whammy bar, but what's its proper name? We call it a whammy bar, but what's its proper name, that bit of the guitar? 0839 33333, and copies of Hank's brand-new album, which is out on Monday, and the guitar tutor could be yours. And Sarah Salinger, you were nearly on the show playing with Hank. We will send you one of these anyway. Paul, hope you enjoyed your class. Hank, thanks very much indeed for coming.
Thank you, Andy.
Cheers.